who's opening the batting.
We thought we called the press conference to say you were.
I suppose the decision to play in the Big Bash, was it your call? Did you want to, or were you asked by the club? Because it's quite a good effort to come in the middle of everything, I guess.
No, certainly it was our call, and I assume it was mutual calls, probably the right way. It's nice that the clubs want to welcome us back and want us back to play, even the likes of the Heat, who are undefeated. But, you know, it's always nice to come back. You know, the way that we've been playing, it's a great energy around the group. I've just got here, and there's a lot of smiles on faces. People are up and about, and it's a pretty uncharacteristic long break between a series. I think it's almost, you know, a week and a half or something like that. You know, we only commence back on Saturday, so there's and then probably start training Sunday. So there's plenty of time to get back into Red Bull mode, and it'd be nice to come out here with the crowd tomorrow.
Great carrot too, Marnus. If you win, you'll finish first. That's a great carrot for the Brisbane Heat too, and for you, up against the Scorchers.
100%. I mean, the Scorchers have been the pick of the team for, you know, the last few years, and to be able to come here tomorrow night and hopefully put in a good performance and help the team finish on top, going into Perth and lock that in, will be massive.
When you left the boys after that first game here at the Gabba in round one, did you like genuinely think this is the position they'd probably be in when you returned?
I mean, it's probably a little bit ambitious for me to say yes, they were going to be 6-0 or 7-0, whatever they are right now. But I thought we had a really good squad. We had great balance. We've got so many good bowling options. You know, the guys that are on the bench are high quality players, and you'll see those guys sort of come in come the pointy end of the season. So, I mean, it's hard to say that undefeated, but certainly I thought we were going to have a good season.
Is it harder to crack into this undefeated team with the Australian Test?
I mean, it's a pretty tough team to crack into, this Heat team, so I'm lucky that I'm here.
Is it a bit disappointing that if the guys finish first and they get all these home finals, they might be on the Goldie?
I mean, yeah, it certainly will be, because, you know, playing on this wicket, undefeated here at home, playing really well, it will be disappointing, but it's another opportunity to take the game to the Gold Coast and really see that the spread of the fans, and see if we can. I mean, I've got no doubt that if the final is at the Gold Coast, that it will be massive.
And I think we're going to see tomorrow is Aussie, and we know he's been in the headlines for his reasons, and we're going to see that for the first time. How's his teammates and the team been around him?
I mean, obviously, I haven't been around this team, but yeah, the team's obviously been very supportive of him and his cause and what he's trying to do. So, I think from a little bit of what I read is he's going to have the opportunity to wheel out the dove tomorrow night, and I think that's going to be I assume very special for him.
The dove has been compared to your decision to put a religious scripture on your bat. Do you draw that comparison, or do you think it's a different sort of circumstance?
Oh, look, it's probably a slightly different circumstance, but, I mean, it's not for me to say if one or the other is wrong or right. But, yeah, it's a slight... I mean, for me, I've had that since 2016, and it was more for myself. It wasn't for anyone else. It was just a reminder for myself of the reason I'm playing the game. Yeah, it's probably slightly different scenarios, but that doesn't mean it's not the right decision to let him have it out there.
And I know you joked about opening the batting in the Test team at LNP, but you did speak quite well the other day about Stephen Smith, how you thought he would go well at it. It's an interesting one, isn't it? You know, what are your further thoughts on that? Because it's such an unusual decision for a guy at his stage to want to do it, isn't it?
I think if Steve does get the nod from Pat and the selectors and the coaches, I've got no doubt that he'll do a good job. And obviously we've seen the likes of, you know, Cameron Green. His record at number four for Western Australia is amazing. I mean, obviously that's not a direct correlation to Test cricket, but I think it's a pretty confident that over a period of time he's going to be a very good player in that position. I think his desire is just one that he's excited for a new challenge. if that motivates him and that gets the cricket world Stephen Smith for another 2 years or 3 years, I think that's a massive win. So if that's the way they go, I'm sure he's going to do a good job. And if they don't, well, he averages 63 at number four, so that's pretty good as well.
It's all about desire, isn't it, Marnus? So, I mean, when players express a desire to do something, and you're Stephen Smith, that speaks a lot. But Cameron Green's wants to bat at four as well, so it looks like a perfect scenario for the Australian team.
Yeah, I mean, I think you're right. It looks like the perfect scenario, but, I mean, for someone like Steve, who's been batting four probably since 2019, since I probably came in at number three, he probably batted when he was captain. I know that he really liked a little bit more time between being in the field and then going out there. But I think I think he's ready to get out there from the start now. So if they go that way, it's be great to support him.
One of the reasons that seems to want to shuffle the top of the order is that you talked about Cam and his potential and what he's done for cricket, and Crash wrote a good thing about, like, he's the future, he's the youngest guy in the squad. Is he the type of guy that you have to move everything around to fit him back in the team? Or that seems like what they're doing here.
I don't know what, once again, I don't know what's going on behind the scenes and who's moving, but it seems like it's more the player that wants to move up rather than moving it around and trying to find a position for Cam. I got no doubt if Cam had to slot into to the number one spot that he would be able to do that as well, and that he'd be able to bat wherever the team needs. But it seems like in this case Steve really wants that opportunity to bat at the top, and if they do end up going that way, then it's sort of like we just said, the perfect swap.
Why do you think Cameron Green's such a good number four? Well, why is he such a good four?
I've seen him get probably 300s here at the Gabba in Shield cricket. Temperament is one. He's got a really nice even temperament. He's got a great ability to absorb pressure. He's a very good decision maker, especially for a guy that's over 2 meters tall. And his technique. I mean, he's got a sound technique. Got a great defence, and I think that's the versatility that you need at number four, is someone that can play different scenarios, know when to push the button, know when to hold back, and I think if he gets into that, if he does get the opportunity to bat at four, I think he's got those qualities. We've seen him do well in the IPL, so we know he's got that button. We've seen him play in England. Extensive periods of short ball bowling and managing that, so I'm sure if they do go down that path that he can manage all these different scenarios.
If the selectors go that way, there's going to be a lot of guys that have been feeling for years that have been battering down the door, especially a guy like Matt Renshaw. Would you feel for a guy like him, a teammate of yours?
It's a tough one. I mean, Cameron Green's batted down the door. He's averaging 50 plus. So just because it's a situational a position, I think they feel that if they go down that way with Steve up top or Cameron up top or whatever they're going to do, and they want to get Cam in, they feel like that's our best six batters in Australia, and they want to go down that path. So I think that's not a kick at all on Shield cricket, what Cameron, Marcus Harris and Matt Renshaw has done. But I think Cameron Green's also averaging 50 plus in Shield cricket. There's not many guys doing that. So I don't think that's a tough comparison to make.
Marty, does age come into it, or even planning for the future? Because outside of Cam, you're the only bloke in the squad under 30.
In the 20s, yeah. In the 20s, that's how I like to say it. I'll enjoy my 7 months. That certainly would come into play. I mean, I'm not a selector, I'm not a coach, but I can only imagine if you've got someone with the ability that's 24, 25 years old, and there's an opportunity to get him in, and there's players willing to move spots because of their desire and what they want to do, and you can fit him in, perfect. It comes back down to, if you want to play the six best batters and they feel Cameron is in those six best batters, then, that's what they'll do.